Hi, my name is Kelsey and I work at the University Branch Library in Sugar Land. And today I'm going to show you how to make an abstract art piece like this.
The supplies you'll need for this project are a canvas, white acrylic paint, other acrylic paints in the colors of your choice, paint brushes, at least a large flat brush and a small detail brush, letter stickers in the style of your choice, a cup for water, a plastic bag, a palette or something to use as a palette, such as a paper plate, and optionally tweezers to remove your letter stickers. You may also want something to protect your work surface, such as a plastic tablecloth or newspaper. To begin, you'll need to choose your quote. For this painting, I'm going to use this quote by Dolly Parton, "Find out who you are and do it on purpose." And I wrote my quote out to make sure I had enough stickers of each letter beforehand. Don't forget to include who said your quote and include that in your letter count. So for this project, we're going to put our stickers down, paint over them, and then take the stickers off to reveal the white of the canvas below. So first, I'm going to put the stickers onto a canvas to mark my quote. You may want to use a pencil and ruler to create light lines to help you lay out your stickers evenly, but I'm going to freehand it like I did in my other painting. I kind of like that it isn't completely straight. It gives it some character and adds to the abstractness of the painting. Make sure to press down to be sure your letters are fully in place. Now that all of my letters are down, I'm going to paint a layer of white paint over them. This will help keep the stickers down and keep colored paint from getting under the stickers, leaving cleaner letters at the end. If you wanted colored letters for your quote, you could try laying a color down before you put your stickers and then layering the same color over your stickers, but you may end up pulling up some of the color with your stickers. You could always use a very small brush to touch up those spots though. And we'll just cover the whole canvas with the white paint for a more cohesive base. And then once you've finished laying the white paint, let it dry completely. I'm going to use pink, red, and purple for my base layer of paint. And I'm using these craft acrylic paints, but you can also use artist acrylic paints like the white I used for the base. Now I'm going to show you how to make the same design I did before, but with abstract painting, you could really lay the color however you want. You could do vertical lines, diagonal lines, shapes, or even splatters, whatever you want. It's about creating something that you want to display. To start, I'm going to lay down each of my colors directly on the canvas in the order I want them to go, starting with the pink, and then I'll do the red, and then the purple. Then I'm going to take a big flat brush and just run it across the first color, spreading it out to cover about a third of the canvas, including the sides. Then I'm going to repeat this separately for each color, rinsing the brush between each color. Once most of the canvas is covered, I'm going to blend the top color and middle color together, adding more paint if needed. Then I'll repeat this where the second color and third color meet. Blend it all together to your liking and then let it dry completely. If the coverage of your paint isn't to your liking, add a second layer or even a third layer. Once you're happy with the base coloring, let it dry completely, and then you can add the top crinkling layer. To get the crinkling effect, I'm going to put some of my gold paint on a paper plate, and then I'm going to scrunch up the plastic bag and dab it into the paint. Then I'm going to dab the bag on my newspaper to get some of the excess paint off so it doesn't cover my painting with too much gold. Then I'm going to dab it all around my canvas, including the sides. If your paint is too thick, you can add a bit of water to thin it out. Once you're happy with the top layer, let it dry completely. Now it is time to take off the stickers. You can try using tweezers to remove the stickers, but for me, just using my nails gives me the best control to remove them. Carefully peel off each sticker, trying not to pull off any paint from the sides with it. This is a slow process, but it leaves you with nice, even letters. As you can see, some of the paint seeped under the stickers, so the letters are not all clean. I'm going to take a very small brush and some white paint and just touch up those areas where the paint is very carefully. Let it dry and then your painting is done. And that's how you make this abstract quote art piece. For more fun craft ideas, check out the library's website. Thanks for watching and have a great day.